Hi guys, so today we're looking at integrating exponential and trigonometric functions. So by the end of this class, you should be able to integrate exponential and trigonometric functions. So three important indefinite integrals are summarized below. These are also found in your log tables on page 26. The integral of e to the power of x with respect to x is e to the power of x plus c. The integral of e to the ax with respect to x equals 1 over a e to the power of ax plus c. And the integral of a to the power of x dx equals a to the power of x over ln a plus c. Okay, let's try a few examples. In example 1, we're given y is equal to e to the power of x and asked to integrate e to the power of x with respect to x. Okay, so we're going to use our first rule here, and the integral of e to the power of x becomes e to the power of x plus c. Let's try another example. We're told that y is equal to e to the power of 5x and therefore asked to integrate e to the power of 5x dx. We're going to use our second rule to integrate this function, and our answer becomes e to the power of 5x over 5 plus c. This may also be written as 1 over 5 times e to the power of 5x plus c. Okay, let's try another example. In example 3, we're told that y is equal to 2 to the power of x, and we're asked to integrate 2 to the power of x dx. Here, we'll use our second rule, and this becomes 2 to the power of x over ln 2 plus c. Okay, let's try another example. Find the integral of 1 over 5x dx. So in this question, our 5 to the power of x is on our denominator. Integrating this gives us 1 over 5 to the power of x divided by ln of 5 plus c. Okay, let's tidy this up. 1 over 5x divided by ln of 5 is the same as writing 1 over ln of 5 times 5 to the power of x plus c. In example 5, we're asked to find the integral of 7 over 5 to the power of x dx. In this case, our first step is to use our multiple rule and take the 7 and write this outside your integral. This gives us 7 times the integral of 1 over 5x dx. Okay, so then we go ahead and integrate our function, giving us 1 over ln 5 times 5 to the power of x. And multiplying in our constant 7 gives us 7 over ln 5 times 5 to the power of x plus c. Okay, let's look at another few examples. So in our log tables, we're told that the integral of 1 over x dx equals ln x plus c. Let's try an example. Integrate 1 over x dx. Using our rule, this becomes ln x plus c. Let's try another example. Integrate 5 over x with respect to x. So first we use our multiple rule and write our multiple outside of our integral. This becomes 5 times the integral of 1 over x dx. We then integrate our function, which becomes ln x plus c, and times it by 5 gives us 5 ln x plus c. Please pause the video and take down these examples. Okay, let's look at the integrals of trig functions. So the integral of cos x dx is equal to sine x plus c. The integral of sine x dx is equal to minus cos x plus c. And the integral of tan x dx is equal to ln sec x plus c. These can all be found on page 26 of your log tables and page 25. for the derivatives. Okay, let's have a look at an example. If f of x is equal to cos of x, find your derivative f prime x. So the derivative of cos of x equals sine of x. In part two, we're then asked to find the integral of the derivative. This equals cos x plus c. The integral of minus sine x dx equals cos x plus c. Let's look at integrating trig functions with respect to the chain rule. So the integral of sine of mx dx is equal to minus cos mx all over m plus c. The integral of cos mx dx equals sine mx over m plus c. And the integral of tan mx dx equals ln sec mx all over m plus c. I.e. integrating trig functions divide by the differential of the angle. Okay, let's try an example question. Find the integral of 5 cos 3x dx. Okay, so here we are looking at this rule. The integral of cos of ax dx is equal to 1 over a sine of ax plus c. So we know from the power rule that we do not integrate our constant multiples. So the integral of 5 cos 3x dx is the same as 5 times the integral of cos 2x dx. And now we integrate our function, which becomes 5 times 1 over 2 sine 2x all plus c, and then multiplying together our terms gives us 5 over 2 sine of 2x plus c, which we can also write as multiplying our fraction by our trig function gives us 5 sine 2x all over 2 plus c. Please pause the video and take down the example. Okay, let's look at another example. Find the integral of cos 5x plus cos 3x dx. So here we have two trig functions that we need to integrate. We will integrate these using the sum rule, i.e. you integrate both functions separately. So this is equal to the integral of cos of 5x dx plus the integral of cos 3x dx. And from here, we integrate both functions using our integrations of trig functions. So the integral of cos of ax dx becomes 1 over a, which in our case is 5, sine of 5x plus 1 over 3 sine of 3x all plus c, some constant which I don't know. Please pause this and take down the following example. Okay, let's look at another example. Here we must use our trig identities with our integration. So example one asks us to write the following products as sums. So we have the function sine 3x sine of x, and we need to write this as a sum. It's important that we do this because when we are integrating functions, We can only integrate functions that are sums of each other, that are separate terms. We cannot integrate functions which are multiplied together. So we must rewrite sine 3x sine x as its sum. So we'll go to our log tables on page 13, 14, and 15. On page 15, we can see that 2 sine A sine B equals cos of A minus B minus cos of A plus B. Rearranging this gives us sine of A sine B equals cos of A minus B minus cos of A plus B, all divided by 2. This is the same as saying 1/2. So just taking out our fraction, 1/2 cos of A minus B minus cos of A plus B equals sine A sine B. And from here, we simply substitute in our angles. So sine of 3x sine x becomes 1 over 2 cos of 3x minus x minus cos of 3x plus x. Okay, so writing that up gives us sine 3x sine x equals 1/2 cos 3x minus x minus cos 3x plus x. And we can simplify this to 1/2 times cos 2x minus cos 4x. All right, let's look at part B. Okay, in part B, we're asked to find each of the following indefinite intervals. So we're asked to integrate sine 3x sine x dx. We know we cannot integrate functions when they are multiplied together. So we use our answer from part A to write this integral as its sums, which is equal to 1/2 cos of 2x minus cos 4x dx. And then using our integral rules, we integrate cos 2x and cos 4x. This gives us 1/2 times sine 2x over 2 minus sine 4x over 4 plus c. Simplifying this, we multiply in our 1/2, which gives us sine 2x over 2 times 2 gives us 4, minus sine 4x, 2 times 4 gives us 8. All plus c. Let's pause the video and take down this example. Okay guys, so it's time for you to try some. Please turn to exercise 15.3, which is on page 396. And complete questions 1, part 1, 2, and 3. Question 3, part 2 and part 4. Question 4, part 1. Question 8, part 1. Part 7. And part 9. Question 9, part 1, part 2, part 3, Question 11. Part 1. Part 3. Question 12. Part 1. Part 3. Part 5. And question 13, part 2, part 3, and B, part 2, and part 3. Please pause this video and take down the questions that you need to do.